Now we can see that there are practically some gaps. Can we see it? There it goes. This is a gap here, and the similar thing goes here. This is another gap, and there is a bigger gap at the bottom of this image. We can see that here goes the gap. Actually, Inkscape, it practically fills color whenever there is a provision, there is a closed circuit everywhere. So in that case, we need to close all those empty paths, empty curves. Like here, we can see that there is a gap between these two lines. So all we can do in this particular case, first of all, let's double click on this image here. And we can see that once we have double clicked, we can see that all those nodal presentations of this individual image is been appearing here. And you can see that this edit paths by nodes option is been selected automatically. In the next case, first of all, there is a gap here. So all we are going to do, we are going to hold this node and we are going to drag it out. And we can see that both the curves, those are practically now joined. So we had closed the gap which was formed right over here. In the similar manner, we will be trying to do something here, but as in this case, if we double click on it and if we try to draw this node, we can see that there is an eerie line or curve is being created, which is unexpected, which is not desired in this particular case. So press Ctrl Z and undo the action that you had done. Next, all we need to do to close this gap, we need to use our pen tool, and we can do something additional like this one. There you can see. So we have practically created two different curves right over here in an attempt to close the gap which is being created right over here. And another thing, we can increase the stroke width right over here, and there it goes. Just increase this stroke width and we can see that everything is back into order. Another thing, there is a gap here. So in an order to fill color to our face, we need to close this gap. So let's double click on it, drag it and drop it here. Similar thing goes here to drag this node and complete the path which is practically creating this face here. Similar thing goes here in case of this ear. There we can see. So all we need to do, we need to close any kind of gaps here before we proceed to fill color to the image that we had imported. Similar thing will be done here. There is another gap. Double click, readjust this node, and everything is almost done. No, the finger is right, good to go. In the last case, this is the gap that we are talking about. Practically in this manner, we won't be able to fill any color to the outfit that he is practically wearing. So in an order to fill color to this outfit, all we need to do, we need to close this larger gap here. So let's grab on this pen tool again, and here we will be creating another path. And now let's increase this stroke style, stroke curve here. We are increasing it and have a look here. If we click on this image, we can see that the image has been chosen, and if we now move it, we can also see that the individual path that we created here, like this one or this one here, those paths are being separated. So this is due to the fact that these paths, those practically lie into a different level. Actually, we won't be keeping all those lines here, like this one or this one. The purpose of these lines are practically to properly fulfill color into the image that we had imported. So we'll be later discarding it off. But in the first case, all we need to do, we need to close all the gaps, those been created right over here. Either you may edit paths by nodes, or you may use your pen tool in an order to close all the gaps, those been created into our imported document. And another gap has been created here. So we need to fulfill this gap too. Now all I'm going to do, I'm going to close all those gaps. I'll be now increasing the width of this stroke right over here. Now let's color this individual image that we have created. This is the fundamental part, coloring an image. But first of all, we'll be going back to the very simple one. We will be using this paint bucket tool here, and we will start filling color. So we can see that the hair has been created here. This is the first case. And another thing, we had practically forgotten to close this gap, so we need to close this gap, else the face color will be occupying this whole individual mouth part here. We don't wish to have so. Head back to this extreme top panel, and we may lower this selection such that this whole individual color, it practically goes down beyond the outline of the image that we had created earlier. So in the same manner, we need to choose this paint bucket tool, and in the next case we will be filling up this gap here. In the similar manner, all we are going to do, we are going to lower our selection to the bottom, and we can see that it has been created, it has been done. In the next case, we need to fill color to this individual face here. So we'll be choosing this paint bucket tool again, and we will be filling color to this individual face. And we can see that this dark color is unintended. We wish to use some different color to this face, and that is why I will be choosing this color. And in the next case, we will be holding down our shift key, and we will be clicking on this same individual color that we had used to fill this face. And we can see that the stroke color now turns into the same. So both the stroke color and the fill color are the same right over here. And in the next case, we are going to lower our selection. In the similar manner, we will be filling up the rest of this part of this face. Now we need to lower our selection. Here it goes. Always repeat these steps once you are filling up any individual color. Similar thing right over here. Now the same thing will be done for this hand option, and for this neck, and a part of the chest. And in either cases, we need to lower our selection at the bottom. Next comes this kurta here, and we'll be selecting this color. So we want to impose some different color to this kurta. So that is why we'll be choosing some different color for it. And we have chosen it, and we have imposed some separate stroke color. I think the stroke color and the fill color is different, so that is why that discrepancy appeared. Now right now it is okay, all right. And we can see that there are some certain gaps here. So in an order to close these gaps, we can do two things. First of all, we may increase this stroke width, and we can edit paths by nodes. We will be dragging it on. Let's drag them, and we may create some additional nodes. Similar thing goes here. So wherever you find that there is a definite gap, all you can do, you may use your edit pass by nodes option to fill up all those gaps. There it goes. Close this enable snapping option. And the next, of course, thing is to send this selection at the bottom. So there it goes. It has been sent at the bottom part. As I have told you previously, that I won't be grouping any kind of lines and curves together with the image outline that we had obtained so far. So I'll be keeping it separate, and you can see that we have kept it separate. So if we now discard this individual line, we can see that practically the bottom part, it is being created right over here, but there is no individual carving at the bottom of this individual image. So this is a very definite option that you can use very too often into your project. I think we have placed it twice, so that is why this is the thing here. So we will be changing this color into something different. There it goes, and we'll be lowering our selection at the bottom, and we can see that the mustache is right now been. So this is how you may fill up color to your project. First of all, you need to trace bitmap of that scanned document or snapped image that you have created, that you have imported into your project. You need to trace bitmap, and you need to turn that individual object into a vector representation. And then all you need to do, you need to fill color into that individual image. So that's it for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we'll be discussing on some definite options in Inkscape, like difference, union, combine, or these sort of things. So hope you guys have liked this tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then,